Welcome dear student and Jai Swami Narayan. In the previous video, we were understand about the acceleration. What do you mean by the acceleration? And position time graph for the accelerated motion and velocity time graph for the accelerated motion. And how we can determine the type of the motion from the velocity time graph. What is the use of the velocity time graph? From the velocity time graph, we can determine the type of the motion. A motion of the object is uniformly accelerated motion, or the motion of the object is a non-uniformly accelerated motion. And second use of the velocity time graph. From the velocity time graph, we can calculate the distance or the displacement traveled by the object, right? So now dear student, with the use of the velocity time graph, with the help of the use of the velocity time graph, we can derive the kinematic equation of the motion for the uniformly accelerated motion. So here we derive a kinematic equations for the uniformly accelerated motion. So first of all, what do you mean by the uniformly accelerated motion? When the object is moving with the constant acceleration, the motion is said to be a uniformly accelerated motion. Now, if from the velocity time graph, how we can get the graph of the velocity time graph of the uniformly accelerated motion? So, if the velocity time graph is a linear straight line, right? The motion is said to be a uniformly accelerated motion, right? So, if the acceleration of an object remains constant with the time, we can say that the motion of the object is a uniformly accelerated motion. So from the velocity time graph, if the velocity time graph is a linear straight line, the motion is said to be a uniformly accelerated motion. And for a uniformly accelerated motion, we derive the velocity relation between the velocity and the time, relation between the distance and the time, and the relation between the velocity and the distance. And these three equations are called the kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion. So first of all, we derive the kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion with the graphical method. With the use of the velocity time graph, we can derive the uniformly accelerated motion. And secondly, we derive the kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion using a differential calculus method. So first of all, consider this velocity time graph as shown in the figure. So consider the velocity time graph for the object moving with the uniform acceleration A. Uniform acceleration, that means a constant acceleration. So suppose the object is moving with the constant acceleration A, we draw a velocity time graph is a linear. So here the velocity time graph is a starting from a point A. It has a some amount of the initial velocity. So here at the time t is equal to 0, the velocity of the object is a v0, is called the initial velocity. So here the velocity of an object at the time t is equal to 0 is a v0, is called the initial velocity. So object start its motion with the some initial velocity v0 and moving with the constant acceleration A. So how we can calculate the acceleration from the graph? You know that the slope of the velocity time graph give us the acceleration. So with the help of the first use of the velocity time graph, here the velocity of the object is continuously increasing with the time, right? And becomes v at the time t equal to t. So here the velocity of the object at the time t equal to 0 is a v0, and the velocity of the object is increasing with the constant acceleration A. At the time t equal to t, the velocity of the object is a v, right? So from the velocity time graph, we can easily calculate the acceleration of the object. And here the acceleration of the object is a constant, and the motion is said to be a uniformly accelerated motion. So how we can calculate the acceleration from the velocity time graph? Yes, the slope of the velocity time graph give us the acceleration during a time interval, right? So the acceleration is the slope of the line AB. So how we can calculate the slope of this line AB? We need a two point A and B on the line, right? So acceleration is equal to slope of the line AB, and it is equal to BC divided by AC. So here from BC, how we calculate the value of the BC? Here at the B, velocity is a V, and at the C, the velocity is a V0. So the value of BC is equal to V minus V0. Similarly, BC divided by AC. So how we can calculate the value of AC? Here at the C, the value is a T, and at the A, the value is 0. So T minus 0, we get the value of AC is a T. So if you put in the acceleration, A is equal to slope BC divided by AC. Value of BC is a V minus V0 divided by value of AC is a T. So from this, we get the acceleration. A is equal to V minus V0 divided by T. So from that, we can easily calculate the velocity of an object after a time T. So if the velocity of the object V at a time T is equal to V0 plus AT. So if we take T on this side, we get V minus V0 is equal to A into T. And from that, V is equal to V0 plus AT. So this is the first kinematic equation for the motion. And this kinematic equation gives the relation between the velocity of an object at any time T, right? The relation between the velocity and the time. So first kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion give us the relation between the velocity and the time. What is the use of this equation? We can calculate the velocity after a time T, right? If you know the initial velocity of the object, acceleration of constant acceleration of the object, and time T. So we can calculate the velocity of an object. We can also calculate the acceleration of an object. We can calculate the time taken to reach at the some point which has a some final velocity. What will be the time required to get a velocity V? We can also calculate. So first use of the kinematic equation is a to calculate the velocity after a time T, to calculate the acceleration, and to calculate the time also to becomes a velocity of the object V. So understand, dear student, how we can derive the velocity time relation using the graphical method. Now, second use of the velocity time graph is from the velocity time graph, we can calculate the displacement of the object or the distance traveled by the object. So with the help of the graphical method, we can derive the relation between the distance and the velocity. How we can calculate the distance from the velocity time graph? Yes, area under the time axis on the velocity time graph represent the displacement or the displacement. So we need to calculate here the area on the time axis gives the distance traveled by the object or the displacement of the object. For the displacement, we take a positive or negative area, right? So for the displacement, if the velocity time graph is above the time axis, we take the displacement positive. And if the velocity time graph is below the time axis, we take the displacement negative, right? So from the velocity time graph, we can calculate the distance or the displacement traveled by the object in a given time interval. How we can calculate? The area covered by the velocity time graph on the time axis gives the displacement or the distance traveled by the object. So for this graph, if the object traveling with the initial velocity V and the constant acceleration A, we need to calculate the area covered by the velocity time graph on this time axis. So here we need to find the distance. To calculate the distance traveled by the object, we need to calculate the shaded area. So here, how we can calculate the shaded area? First, we calculate the area of the triangle ABC, and then we calculate the area of the rectangle ABCD, and the total area is the sum of the area of the triangle and the sum of the area of the rectangle. This gives the distance traveled by the object, or we can say that the displacement of the object. So the displacement x is equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of rectangle ACDO. How we can calculate the area of triangle, right angle triangle ABC? Yes, 1/2 into the base into the height. So here 1/2 base is a AC. So we take a AC is equal to T and height it is equal to BC. We take a BC is equal to V minus V0. So area of triangle ABC is equal to 1/2 into height V minus V0 into base T, right? Plus, how we can calculate the area of rectangle? Area of rectangle is equal to length into the height. So here the length we take a CD or AO, it is equal to V0 minus 0. We get a V0, and length is equal to 0 T minus 0, we get a T. So area of rectangle is equal to OD multiplied by CD, length into the breadth. So length here we get a T and breadth we get a V0 from the graph. So area of rectangle is V0 into T, right? So we get the displacement x is equal to 1/2 into V minus V0 into T plus V0 into T. But from the equation number 1, so look at the previous equation. From this equation number 1, V minus V0 is equal to A into T, right? So from the equation number 1, we get V minus V0 is equal to A into T. So put V minus V0, instead of this V minus V0, we put A into T. We get the second equation of the displacement, and it is the relation between the distance or the displacement with a time, right? X is equal to V0T, we take a first, plus 1/2 V minus V0 is equal to A into T, that is a AT square. So we get the second kinematic equation for the uniform accelerated motion, and this equation represents the relation between the distance or the displacement with the time, right? So here x is the distance or the displacement, distance traveled by the object, V0 is the initial velocity, A is the acceleration, and T is the time. Here the acceleration A is a constant. So x is equal to V0T plus 1/2 AT square is the second kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion, and it gives the relation between the distance and the time. Now let us see how we can derive the third equation, that is the relation between the velocity and the distance. So to derive the third equation of the motion, from the definition of the average velocity, what is the average velocity? Definition of the average velocity: average velocity is equal to displacement divided by time. So from that, the displacement is equal to the average velocity multiplied by time, right? So now here the initial velocity is V0 and the final velocity is V. How we can get the average velocity of the object? Yes, average velocity of the object is a V plus V0 divided by 2 into time T. So we get the displacement from the definition of the average velocity, x is equal to V plus V0 divided by 2 into T, right? But from the equation number 1, right, V minus V0 is equal to AT, we get T is equal to V minus V0 divided by A. So instead of this T, we put a V minus V0 divided by A, right? So we get the displacement or the distance traveled by the object, x is equal to V plus V0 divided by 2 into V minus V0 divided by A. So instead of this T, we place a V minus V0 divided by A. So if we take a, if we deduce this formula, V plus V0 into V minus V0, we get a V square minus V0 square. A plus B, A minus B, we get a square minus V square. So similarly here, V plus V0, V minus V0, we get a V square minus V0 divided by 2A. So from this, we get the third equation, 2ax, we take this 2a in, on this side, we get a 2ax is equal to v square minus v0 square. So we get the third kinematic equation of the motion. Here a is the constant acceleration, x is the distance, v is the final velocity, and v0 is the initial velocity. So the third equation, kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion gives the relation between the distance and the initial velocity and the final velocity. So it gives the relation between the velocity and the distance. So dear student, understand how we can derive the kinematic, all the three kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion with the graphical method. Dear student, here we assume that the motion of the object starts from the initial position x equal to 0, right? So we get a three kinematic equation, v is equal to v0 plus 8t, x is equal to v0 plus 1 half 8t square, and v square is equal to v0 square plus 2ax, or v square minus v0 square is equal to 2ax. This kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion is most useful. From this equation, we can get the final velocity, displacement, time, acceleration, all the physical quantity regarding the motion of the object can be calculated with the help of these three kinematic equation. But in this, to derive this graphical method, kinematic equation, we assume that the position of the particle at the time t is equal to 0 is a 0, right? So we obtain the kinematic equation for the uniform acceleration by assuming that at the time t equal to 0, the position of the particle x is a 0, right? But always the position of the particle is not x equal to 0. Initially the object start at the some position, right? So we can obtain a more general form of the kinematic equation by taking a x initial position time, at the time t equal to 0, the initial position of the object is a x0. It is a non-zero value. So how we can modify the equation? The equation can be modified by replacing x by a x minus x0. So we get the first equation, it remains unchanged because in that there is no value of the position x. So v is equal to v0 plus 8t. But instead of this x, if we replace x by a x minus x0, we get x minus x0 is equal to v0t plus 1 half 8t square, right? So we get the general form of the kinematic equation, x is equal to x0 plus v0t plus 1 half 8t square, where x0 is the initial position of the object. If the initial position of the object is 0, we put x0 is equal to 0. And third equation, v square minus v0 square is equal to 2ax. So we get a v square minus v0 square is equal to 2a into x minus x0. Or we can write like this also, v square is equal to v0 square plus 2a into x minus x0. So dear student, understand the general form of the kinematic equation. In that we take a initial position x0. If the initial position of the object starting at a 0, we take a x0 is equal to 0. So similarly, we can derive all the three kinematic equation of the uniform accelerated motion by a differential calculus method. So dear student, now let us see, obtain the equation of the motion or kinematic equation of the motion for a constant acceleration using a method of calculation, using a method of the differential calculation. So it is given in the form of the example in the textbook, example number 3.3, obtain the equation of the motion for the constant acceleration using a method of calculus, right? So second method to derive the kinematic equation for the constant accelerated motion is a method of differential calculation. So how we can derive all the three equations previously we derived using a method of calculus? Let us see. So dear student, first of all, how we can derive the first kinematic equation for the motion, for the uniformly accelerated motion, right? So by the definition of the acceleration, what is the acceleration? The rate of change of velocity is called the acceleration. So by the definition of the acceleration, A is equal to the dv by dt. Differentiation of the velocity with respect to time give us the acceleration. So by the definition of the acceleration, A is equal to dv by dt. So from that we get dv is equal to A into dt. So we use the integrating both sides. In this method we use the integration. So dear student, up till now you don't know the how we can perform the integration. See the video number 6 of the chapter number 0 for the integration and the rules of the integration. So dear student, before solve this example, see the video number 6 for the video number 6 of the chapter number 0 for the integration and the rules of the integration. So here integrating both sides, we get integration of v0 to v into dv is equal to integration of 0 to t a into dt. So here the v0 is the initial velocity of the object and v is the final velocity of the time t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t, right? So integrating this term, we get integration of the dv. For the integration, again I repeat, the for the integration, see the video number 6 of the chapter number 0, right? And rules in that, you understand about what do you mean by the integration, what are the rules of the integration, how we can perform the integration. So here the integration of the dv is equal to v, and we put a limit v0 to v, and is equal to a. Here a is the acceleration, and here we take the acceleration is a constant. So we take out of the integration, and the integration of the dt, we take a integration of the dt is a t from 0 to t. Now first the limit of the integration, first put a upper limit of the integration instead of this v, put a v, so we get a v minus v0, and a constant acceleration a is a, and here if you put the upper limit minus lower limit, so t minus 0, we get a t. So we get the first equation of the motion is the v is equal to v0 plus a t. So dear student, understand how we can derive the first kinematic equation of the motion using a differential calculus method, using a integration method. Now we'll derive the second kinematic motion equation of the kinematic equation for the motion, right, with the help of the integration method. So for the second equation is the relation of the distance and the time. So for that we know that the formula of the velocity v is equal to dx by dt. Differentiation of the position with respect to time give us the velocity. So v is equal to dx by dt. From that we get a dx is equal to v into dt. So integrating this both side, we get integration of the dx x0 to x. Here x0 is the initial position and x is the final position. Dx integration of 0 to 2 v into dt. Here t is equal to 0 is the final time, initial time, and t equal to t is the final time. So here, but from the equation number 1, we know that v is equal to v0 plus at. So put the value of v is equal to v0 plus at and dt before integrating this term. So integration of x0 to x dx is equal to integration 0 to 2 v0 plus at into dt, right? So what is the integration of the dx? Integration of the dx is a x. Similarly, integration of the dv is a v. Similarly, here integration of dx is a x, x0 to x. Further, we put a limit, upper limit first, minus lower limit. Now, perform the integration of this term. Here, a is the constant, right? So, v0 is a constant. Integration of the dt is a d, right? Plus, a is a constant. Integration of the t dt is a t square by 2. So, here, by mistake, we put here a, but this a is not there, right? So integration of this term is a v0 t plus a into t square by 2, right? So v0 is constant, integration of dt is a t plus a is constant, integration of t dt is a t square by 2. So we get the integration of this term is the v0t plus a into t square by 2. So understand, dear student, how we perform the integration of this term. Integration of dx is a x, we put a limit x0 to x. Integration of v0 plus ad is a v0t plus a constant t square by 2, we put a limit 0 to t. So here first put a upper limit x minus lower limit x0, we get a x minus x0. Here we put a upper limit t, it did not require to put a limit 0, right? So we get a v0t plus 1 half a t square. So here we get the second kinematic equation for the motion. X is equal to x0 plus v0t plus 1 half a t square. If the initial position of the object is 0, we get x is equal to v0t plus 1 half a t square. Second kinematic equation for the constant accelerated motion. So now, dear student, let us see how we can derive the third kinematic equation for the motion. So to derive the third kinematic equation for the motion, we know that acceleration a is equal to dv by dt. Now here multiply by dx and divide by dx, we get dv by dx multiply by dx by dt. So if you think about here dx dx plus, we get a dt by dt. So dv by dx into dx by dt. But we know that dx by dt, the differentiation of the position with respect to time is a velocity. So instead of this dx by dt, we put a v into dv by dx. So we get acceleration a is equal to v dv by dx. So from that we take a v dv is equal to a into dx, right? So v dv is equal to a into dx. Integrating both sides, we get the third kinematic equation of the motion. So here integration from v0 to v, v into dv is equal to integration from x0 to x, a into dx. So here integration of the v dv is a v square by 2. We put a limit v0 to v. Here a is a constant. Integration of the dx is a x. We put a limit x0 to x. So here first we put a limit, upper limit. So v square by 2 minus lower limit v0 square by 2 is equal to a into upper limit x minus x0. So we get the third kinematic equation. If we take this two on the other side, v square minus v0 divided by 2 is equal to a into x minus x0. So v square minus v0 is equal to 2a into x minus x0. We get the third kinematic equation for the motion. So dear student, understand how we can derive the kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion, constant accelerated motion, right? All the three equation of the motion is most important for the example solution, and this kinematic equation for the motion is important for the JEE and NEET also. So dear student, remember this all the three kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion. When the object is moving with the constant acceleration, we use any of the three equation to calculate the velocity of the object, distance of the object, right? So dear student, I hope that you understand both the method to calculate the kinematic equation for the uniformly accelerated motion. Thank you very much for watching my video.